इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स कूलम्स लॉ टू पॉइंट चार्जेस सेपरेटेड बाय सम डिस्टेंस आर द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्सन बिटवीन देम इज एफ देन दिस फोर्स इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द चार्जेस क्यू वन क्यू टू एंड इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम कंबाइनिंग दिस फोर्स इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ चार्जेस बाई डिस्टेंस स्क्वायर एंड द कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी इज के वेयर के इज इक्वल टू वन बाई फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो इन एसआई सिस्टम विच इज इक्वल टू नाइन इंटू टेन रेज टू द पावर नाइन एंड इफ यू सी द यूनिट्स सो एफ इंटू आर स्क्वायर इट विल बी न्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर एंड दिस इज कूलम एंड कूलम सो न्यूटन मीटर स्क्वायर पर कूलम स्क्वायर नाउ दिस इज कूलम्स लॉ सो व्हाट इज कूलम्स लॉ सो फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्सन बिटवीन टू पॉइंट चार्जेस सो टू पॉइंट चार्जेस कैन अट्रैक्ट ईच अदर और रिपेल ईच अदर द फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ चार्जेस क्यू वन एंड क्यू टू इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम हियर द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम इज आर सो इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम एंड सो वी गेट putting this constant of proportionality. So this is the expression. This is the value of k in SI system. Now we have this new constant 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. So epsilon 0 is another constant and this constant is called permittivity. Permittivity of free space. So permittivity of free space it is an electrical constant and it has also a value and this is equals to 8.85 into 10 raised to the power minus 12. So this is about Coulomb's law. Now let us see if the product of charges q1 and q2 the product is positive. It implies that the force will be positive and positive force means it is repulsion. So there will be repulsion between the charges. If the product of charges Q1, Q2 is negative, means force will be negative and it is attraction. So when the product of charges is positive means both the charges are like charges, either both are positive or both are negative. And when the product is negative, it means one of the charge is positive and another charge is negative. So this force will be attractive in nature. Now we come to the other aspect of Coulomb's law, that is vector form. Vector form. Okay, what is the need of vector form? We know that force is not a scalar quantity, force is a vector quantity. And suppose I will take the two charges. This is the coordinate system, x-axis and y-axis I draw. I will take one charge and this charge is Q1 charge and I will take another charge and this charge is Q2 charge. So the position of charge Q1 when measured from origin is R1 vector and the position of charge Q2 when measured from origin is r2 vector. Now we know that suppose both the charges are positive, so the direction of force will be repulsive and it will repel this charge. So what is the force on q2 by q1 called? So we use a notation F21. So F21 means force on second charge by the first charge. Now the direction of this force is from 1 to 2. So the direction can be represented by a unit vector, and that unit vector is called R21 cap. So when we use this cap, it represents a unit vector. Now let us see this R21 cap. What is the meaning of this R21 cap? So what is the meaning of R21 cap? So when I write R21 cap, it simply means vector R21 by R21 magnitude. Okay, what is R21? R21 vector is the displacement vector starting from 1 to 2. You can see that 2 is the final and 1 is the initial position. So R21 means it starts at 1 and ends at 2. So this is R21 vector, displacement from 1 to 2. So here what I will write R21 vector as, R21 vector is simply R2 vector minus R1 vector. Now we have already done vectors and we know how to find the displacement vector, displacement between two vectors, displacement between two points. So now there is an important aspect with associated with this vector law, and that is, as we know, all the real forces obey Newton's third law. So here it is not the exception, and F21 vector is equals to minus F12 vector. So force on second vector by first vector, force on second charge by first charge is equal to force on first charge by second charge. And these two forces are equal and opposite. We'll continue next part in next video lecture. Please keep continuing.